Hi, my name is Steve Fielding, and I welcome you to the Revere Rosetti Collin Senior Center Senior News. And we're the number one senior news station in Revere, maybe because we're the only ones. I have a special guest today. Her name is Pamela Pattavina, and she's the Director of Business Development for the P.A.C.E. program. Welcome, Pamela.
Nice to be here, Stephen. Thank you.
Now, Pamela is sitting in Morris's seat. If you are a regular watcher of this TV program, you know that Morris has been out of the picture for quite a while, and we wish him well. I spoke to him yesterday. He is progressing. We miss him. And if you're watching the show, Morris, I just want to say we can't wait to have you come back, and we wish you well, and our thoughts and prayers are with you as you recover from your recent car accident. So before we begin and talk to Pamela about the P.A.C.E. program, I'm just going to go over some things that are happening in February at the Rosetti Collin Senior Center. As you all know, this is going to be for the February issue of the Senior News. So since we're in the middle of winter and we haven't had too much snow, knock on wood, and we've had a mild winter so far, I just want to give the weather cancellation policy for seniors as a reminder. We haven't done this yet, although it has been placed right on the newsletter. But I just want to read it to seniors just so they're aware of it, because I know a lot of you watch the show. The Rosetti Collin Senior Center will be closed, and the senior shuttle van service will not operate whenever the Revere Public Schools are canceled due to inclement weather. So please be advised that if the weather is creating a commuting problem, regardless of whether the schools are open or closed, use your discretion. Call the Rosetti Collin Senior Center at 781-286-8156 just to check out to see if we're open to the public. So I ask you to do that, and that way we don't have you in a danger zone. We want to make sure you're all safe out there. So before we talk to Pamela about the P.A.C.E. program and what's happening with that, I just want to go over several things that are happening at the Rosetti Collin Senior Center during the month of February. We do have a new computer class that's starting up again in February. It's a 5-session class. The ratio is 1 teacher to every 5 students. It's very basic computer skills, very basic, but it's perfect for seniors. So if you're interested in signing up for a computer class, call Camille at 781-286-8156, and she'll put you on the list. We have a great instructor, Brenda Ladderbush, and this is going to be her third class coming up. So it's a great thing for the seniors to learn basic computer skills. Our book club is run by Revere librarian Janice Van Hoekeman. It's the third Thursday of every month, and in February, it will be held on February 16th, which is from 2:30 to 3:30. So we hope you can join us and discuss books and current events. We also have a movie each Wednesday instead of bingo. Well, we are the only senior center in the country that has bingo 4 days a week. And we have a great movie, and we get the movies off of Redbox through the library. And Janet at the library is terrific in bringing us up to date in new releases. We do have a monthly luncheon every month. In February, we're going to have a Valentine's Day dance party. Now, if you don't think seniors can dance, you ought to come down. They're like teenagers. They get up there and move. And we have a great DJ. His name is Steve the Dude Capano. Steve has been down before. And it's a special monthly luncheon, so you have to call ahead of time. And we'd like you to call before February 10th, because the event is February 16th from 12, which is the lunch period, until 1 o'clock. And you can dance till the night's over. I don't care. As long as you're having fun, that's what counts. We have a blood pressure consultation with Carol Donovan, our city nurse, and it's held on February 9th and February 23rd from 11 o'clock to 12. We also have Mary Marino to check our monthly hearing and have a consult with Mary. She's there from every on Thursday, February 23rd from 10 to 12. We have another woman named Barbara McDonald. She comes and does a chair massage, and that's great for seniors, just to limber up. And she will be at the Senior Center on Monday, February 13th at 9:30. That one you have to call up and set an appointment, because she does get busy. We also have a monthly podiatry clinic with Dr. Kaplan. Many of you know him. He's there on the first Wednesday of every month. And this month in February, it will be February 1st. You don't need to call up, but you need to come early because it does fill up fast. So before we talk to Pamela, I just want to mention one more thing. We have a great shuttle program and a meals program. If you go on www.revere.org, go on to the Elder Affairs Department, check out our quick links on the left-hand corner of that page. You'll see the monthly menu, the shuttle service information, and all the activities, programs, and services. We have one event that's very important for seniors to be aware of in February. H&R Block, Mike Evendahl, who is the manager of the Revere branch, will be joining us at 12:30, and he'll be providing tips for seniors, tax tips for seniors. So if you come down to the Rossetti Cowan Senior Center, 25 Washington, Winthrop Ave, I'm sorry, he will be there at 12:30. And you don't need to make a call, you don't need to reserve it. You just come on down and maybe you can find out something that will help you. So now that we got the business and all the housekeeping stuff out of the way, I want to reintroduce Pamela Pattavina. She's the Director of Business Development at the PACE program. And Pamela, why don't you tell us a little about the PACE program?
Well, the PACE program here in Revere has actually been around for, if you can believe it, 27 years. And we were one of the first PACE programs in the country, at least on the East Coast. We started out in California with a program called OnLock. And OnLock means happy, healthy abode in Cantonese. And that's exactly what we want to do, keep you happy, healthy in your abode or home with a PACE program.
So let me ask you, for all the people out there that aren't aware of this, what does PACE stand for?
Ooh, it's a tricky one. Program for All Inclusive Care for the Elderly. And I hate that word elderly, I really do, because we take care of folks that are 55 years and older. Do you know anyone 55, Stephen?
Yes, I do. I don't consider them elderly either.
And neither do we. So we'd like that name taken out of it. But it's 55 and older, 55 to 105. Our oldest person right now is 106 years old.
So let me ask you this. You work for the Elder Service Plan.
Yes, I do.
And what's the relationship between the Elder Service Plan, PACE, and the East Boston Neighborhood Health Center? How does that all tie in together?
Okay, so the East Boston Neighborhood Health Center is a physical place located in East Boston that primarily has primary care, pediatric care, and other services in a couple of locations in East Boston and now in Winthrop. I work for the section called the Elder Service Plan, which is a PACE program. We call the Elder Service Plan ESP for short. So if that doesn't confuse you, I don't know what will. But they're all the same thing. Our mission is to keep people happy and healthy at home.
Now, one of the advantages, or maybe I'm wrong, but is the primary advantage of the PACE program is that, for lack of a better term, it's a one-stop shop for all your medical needs?
People like to think of it as one-stop shopping. Can't say that too easily. And people do come to what we call a PACE center. And there they can see the doctor, the nurse practitioner. They can get rehabilitation therapy, physical therapy, occupational therapy. And they can get some social activities too. But we're a little bit more than that. We also tie into the community. And some of our folks might also belong to the senior center, like the Revere Senior Center. So we provide health care when you need it in a location called a PACE center, but we also help you do better in the community.
Okay. So one of the things that you have been trying to do as you rented Revere a few years back is to create an opportunity for older Americans, as opposed to the elderly, to utilize the services that you have for the PACE program. And you have some very exciting news to talk about in regard to the PACE program in Revere.
I do. We're very happy to let you know that hopefully in about 18 months, maybe a little bit less, we will be in Revere. We've picked out a location. It is a VFW hall that we will be completely renovating to 15,000 square feet just for seniors. It's really going to be something special. It sits right on the marsh. So out back, we're going to have a large patio for those that like bird watching and things like that. And I think it'll just be great for the community. We're looking forward to it, Stephen.
Now, I came down to a meeting, a neighborhood meeting, and I saw the rendering of the design.
And what'd you think?
I thought it was fantastic. I'm going to tell people where it is exactly. I mean, it's no secret in Revere.
No, it's no secret.
So if you're from Revere, you know where the Matola Post is. The Matola Post has been there for quite a long time. So that piece of property with the parking area and that building will be raised.
Yes.
And as a result of your hard work and everybody else's hard work at the PACE program and with the architecture firm, you have designed a beautiful Cape Cod-looking style one-story building, correct?
Yes, it's one story, yes.
Yeah. So why don't you tell us what is going to be housed there inside and what kind of services that will be taking place there?
So it'll be what we call a very large center. So we will have doctors there, and those doctors are board-certified geriatricians. We'll have a complete rehab gym for those folks that need physical therapy and occupational therapy. We'll have social workers there to help. We will have a variety of other types of clinics for blood pressure, things like that. Folks can come in at any time for, you know, look, anything as simple as taking care of a cold or maybe having some labs drawn. It really is a full service clinic, Stephen. But more than that, we have a great social space. Mm-hmm. So folks can come in and do activities all day long. And that's nice for some people who can't get out to other places like the Senior Center.
Right. I'm looking forward to it. And before I get into a couple of other things in regard to the relationship we have with your organization, us as the Senior Center I'm speaking of, one of the ideal components of this PACE program is the transportation.
Yes.
So why don't you talk about what your transportation services are to help get the people there and home and what the hours might be and mm-hmm. how that's going to work.
Well, I think we can all relate to if anybody takes care of parents or, you know, other relatives that need help getting to transportation to and from doctor's appointments or to and from anything, and you have to take time off from work. It's really, really difficult to do. So what we do is we offer transportation. We have 21 vans that are handicapped accessible, and we take people door to door. And when I say door to door, I don't mean just to the front stoop. I mean into the home and into the apartment or into somebody's house. And that's so important because people know that once they're home, their family members know they're safe.
Fantastic. Now, because you and I have worked together and mm-hmm. we built a relationship with the entire, you know, East Boston Neighborhood Health Center umbrella and the services from the Elder Service Plan and the PACE program, we do have a lot of seniors at the Rosetti Cowan Senior Center that utilize the PACE program. So this will be ideal for them. And hopefully more will take advantage of it because you can go to Revere instead of into Boston.
Yes.
You know, so, and if need be, you can make arrangements for somebody to go to Boston and the Boston Medical Center or wherever, you know, they may need to go.
That's true. The other thing is I want people to know that we're just sort of an extension of the community. Think of us as like your good health care out there. But it doesn't mean that you don't do other things. You can still go to the Senior Center. You can still go to Bingo.
Right, right.
You can still go to other places. We just want to help you stay healthy so you can do all of those things.
And, you know, I want people to realize this, and I've talked about it many times, and I always talk about the fact that East Boston Neighborhood Health Center and the Elder Service Plan donated a van, although it was a used van, it's very helpful, to the Senior Center 3.5 years ago when I first got the job there. And one of the nice things about it is there is advertisement on the van. So we have already established a good connection. So hopefully we can partner and do additional things for our seniors to take advantage of your organization's opportunities at the PACE Center once it's up and going. And then for you guys to come down and work with our seniors as well. Maybe we can combine programs as well. There's a lot of potential here.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And, yeah, and it doesn't mean it has to be medically related. It could be educational. It could be exercise related. Mm-hmm. It could be health related. Informative presentations.
Yep.
And you have a lot of expertise in this organization, the PACE program.
And we work with all kinds of organizations here in Revere already. We do work with the Revere Housing Authority, and we're out there regularly doing different kinds of programs, as Stephen said, exercise programs, healthy eating, all kinds of things. And I'm sure over the course of this year, Stephen will have us coming down to the Senior Center to do a few more things. And I wanted to mention that we did physically relocate to Revere, so we are very happy to be on Revere Beach. We are at 300 Ocean Ave on the fourth floor. And if you ever wanted to come and stop by, you could give us a call ahead at 617-568-6377. Or you could just come and stop by. We're open from 8:30 in the morning till 4:30. And you could sit and talk to somebody about your needs.
Now, a lot of older Americans have already established a relationship with a particular doctor or a hospital. When they come to talk to somebody about the PACE program, of course, they're going to be concerned if they can use their own doctor. Is it going to be a low cost? But there are many advantages beyond what they're currently may be using. Mm-hmm. So how would you talk to somebody about that if they had those kind of concerns?
Well, I think everybody has the concern of leaving their doctor. It's hard to do. You've made an established relationship with somebody, but oftentimes the doctor may be retiring too.
Right.
So they are looking. And I think most doctors are very, very interested in you having what you need, where you need it, and that's where we can come in. So we are delivering care in the home if you need it there, and in the PACE Center. It gives you a lot more options, and you have a team of specialists. So you not only have a registered geriatrician, nurse practitioner, registered nurses, but you also have social workers and therapists and other people to help you. So it's more inclusive than what you would get with your primary care physician. And I have to tell you that I've been doing this for 11 years, and I know it's hard, and people can always leave the program if they don't like it, but I have had nobody ever leave the program because they wanted to go back to their primary physician.
But a great thing with the PACE program is if you belong to this program, it allows you to continue to be independent in your home more than probably other types of organizations offer.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely. Our mission is to keep you at home safely for as long as you want to be at home and independently, and really avoid a nursing home. That's what we're all about.
So if you belong to the PACE program and you're home and you need a ride to your doctor,
you get one.
You get one. Then you may have to go see a specialist, and that specialist may be at the new PACE Center.
Absolutely.
So you go there, and the transportation takes you there, and then it can take you home.
Absolutely.
And so there's a lot of good things that come out of becoming a member of the PACE program. There's no doubt about that.
And there's something else that I think people sometimes forget, and it's called the coordination of care. I don't know if you've ever been, out to, say, your dentist, and your dentist says, wow, your back seems a little off. You should go see your primary. And you go see your primary, and they recommend somebody else. We have one single electronic medical record, and everybody inputs into that. So no matter where you are, no matter who you are seeing, everybody knows what happened. And you don't have to remember to repeat that to everyone. Same with pharmacy. All your medications are coordinated by one team.
Right.
Everybody knows what you're taking, Stephen, and that makes a big difference to folks.
Well, in addition to the medical care you might get, or the need for prescription monitoring or whatever it might be, the PACE program also helps you plan your meals. You have nutritionists on staff, you have physical therapists on staff, so you have an array of specialists to administer to the people who are members, right?
Exactly.
Okay.
We have three registered dietitians, one at each site, and then another one at the Wellness Center to make four. And those people make sure that all of the meals that are prepared are in your best medical interest. We even have classes over at our Wellness Center, so you can learn how to cook salt-free and other things like that. But always, it's there for you. It's the right meal for you, not for anybody else. And on the pharmacy side, I want to say also that all of your medications are included in the plan. So there's no out-of-pocket expense for people.
Mm-hmm.
Huge. And sometimes, depending on what you're on, over-the-counter medications are covered too. Because again, our goal is to keep you not sick, not in the hospital, but healthy.
Now, I know you have a wellness center segment of the PACE program. So that's basically to prevent you from becoming, I'm not sure what the word is, susceptible to the wrong diet, to the wrong lifestyle.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a big focus for you guys too, right?
Yep. We know that if we can avoid you going into the hospital and we can teach you some preventative health and some good healthy habits, you're going to do better. There we have a full service gym. People do great. I think overall our last class lost a little over like 250 pounds, mm-hmm. which was great. And we also have chronic disease management sort of self-help programs. So if you had, you know, CHF or congestive heart failure, or you had COPD, we'd teach you how to deal with those diseases. Not only like what to do from like a medical perspective, like what to take for medications, but how to eat and maybe how to talk about that disease. And we have acupuncture, we have Feldenkrais, we have yoga, we have some Latin dance programs, and people really, really enjoy it. If they're getting out and moving, they do better.
So if somebody is watching the show and they're interested in learning more about the PACE program,
yes.
Why don't you give them a phone number or website or contact information so that, you know, even before your building is built,
yes.
in a year and a half, they can
certainly
check you
join
out.
Now. We have three programs running right now, three PACE centers, two in East Boston and one in Winthrop. So folks can go to those centers until we open in Revere. Again, our call number is 617-568-6377, and you'll probably get Luis. He's our intake person, and he'll be happy to help you. And we speak 36 languages, so if English is not your primary language, we can also help you.
And you can also call the Revere Rossetti Cowan Senior Center at 781-286-8156. I'll be happy to talk to you about the PACE program. Mm-hmm. Pamela has provided us with all kinds of information regarding their services and contact information regarding an array of different components that make up the PACE program. So please feel free to call us at the Senior Center as well. And like we were talking earlier, we will have the folks down from the PACE program on a more regular basis. I know you were coming down quite a bit mm-hmm. over the last, you know, 2.5-3 years. And you've been kind of focused on this building and moving into Revere and setting things up. And I know you did move your administrative office to Revere, so.
We did, and now we're there and we're close. I'm happy to come down. And as I said, many people on my team, Tricia is anxious to come down and do some arthritis exercise teaching, which is always great for people to limber up and feel a little better.
Yep, and you've come down for some of our special monthly luncheons and had tables and talked to the folks about what you have there. And you've always brought prizes and things like that for seniors, which they love. And like you said, Tricia came down and immediately after lunch, you know, she got the folks up and started moving them around a little bit. And even if they couldn't stand too well, they were in their chairs doing arthritis exercises and just having movement. And it's funny because I just read an article from the National Institutes of Health that the biggest obstacle for seniors, or elderly as they call them, is non-movement.
Absolutely.
And if you don't move, you're in trouble. I have seniors at the Senior Center that say, oh, I can't move, I have to sit here, I have neuropathy because of diabetes on my feet. And I said, you know what, if you sit for 4 hours, that's even gonna make it worse. I try to get and encourage the seniors that we get every day on a daily basis. Mm-hmm. Every 20 minutes, everybody's gonna get up. We're gonna walk around the dining hall. We're gonna take the elevator upstairs. We're gonna walk around the hall up there through the bocce court all the way down. So, you know, the idea is to get seniors on their feet, even if it's just for a limited time.
Yep.
You need to do that.
They say just 10 minutes.
10 minutes is all you need.
Yep.
And I'm gonna segue into, before we launch our goodbye here, at the Senior Center, we do have two core and balance classes every week. We have a yoga and meditation class. We have two of them every week. We have a combo exercise class. We have a Zumba toning class. We have a Zumba goal class. These are things that many seniors take advantage of. They don't even need to get out of their chair if they can't. They go up and they can even move like this or like that. It
it's
doesn't
about
matter.
Doing what you can.
It's right. It's right. And they say even if you have arthritis or a serious problem with mobility, it's still good to try to move a little bit, and we encourage that. So before we close the show, I just want to give you an opportunity to summarize or say anything more about the PACE program, and then I'll just wrap it up and we'll call it a day.
So real quick, if you're 55 years and older, great program just to explore. may not be right for you, might be great for a neighbor, but it doesn't cost a thing to take a look at it. And I have to say, I think it's one of the best kept secrets around.
And one of the things I'm trying so hard to do, and I have tried over the last 3.5 years, is to make the Rossetti Cohen Senior Center a non-secret. And
yes.
I think we've been able to attain that a little bit. I mean, we're in the paper, we're in the website, we're on the senior news here. We have the newsletter here. We're fortunate to have both the Revere Journal and the Revere Advocate help us promote the Senior Center. Thankfully, we have Revere TV to give us the opportunity here. And I thank Bob Dunbar, Bobby Driscoll, Rick Promise. They're so great to the Revere seniors. Every month they come down and they tape our special monthly luncheons. And I can't tell you how many seniors say, oh, I saw the show, I was there, I saw myself on TV. It's so nice for them to enjoy themselves because they can't get out by themselves, you know. They can't drive, a lot of them. And at night, you know, it's tough for them to get out and go see some entertainment and have a nice dinner. So this provides a good opportunity. That's why that's so important. We have a lot of things other than bingo. We have a great 80-inch flat screen smart TV that the Northeast Vocational High School just put up for us a few weeks back. We have up-to-date movies every week. We put on the inaugural, the day of the inaugural, we put that on.
Excellent.
We had 35, 40 seniors came in early to watch that. So it's fantastic. So they take advantage of that. We have a lot of people come in and talk about different topics. I don't try to overwhelm the seniors because a lot of organizations try to come in and sell. And we just, but you're welcome anytime. You're
Thank
selling something
you.
That they can take advantage of and that they would truly benefit from. Mm-hmm. It's really something.
And I think it's just important to know because it's not everywhere. We're lucky, Stephen. It's not in every town.
That's
it's
right.
not in every state.
And the last thing I want to say before I sign off is I highly encourage seniors 55 plus to at least research the PACE program. Give them a call. Go online. They're online on their own website. Check them out. This is a great opportunity because they're moving to Revere. So if you check them out now, you're at an advantage. You'll
Absolutely.
Already have been put into the system, you know, should you decide to make a change. And I just want to wrap up by saying, again, Morris, we miss you. We wish you well. We want you to come back, and we hope that you will. We have confidence that you will. I want to thank all the seniors that do come to the Rossetti Cohen Senior Center, and I highly encourage those that don't, come down and check us out. Have a tour, a personal tour. I will take you on a tour. On our website, on www.revere.org, we have the Elder Affairs Department homepage. There's a video, which hopefully Bob Dunbar of Revere TV and I will update, but it gives you a kind of a flavor of what kind of activities we have, what kind of environment we have. It's a warm, safe, positive, fun environment for seniors. Come on down.